Welcome to our little tale of woe, triumph against impossible odds, terror, and managerly responsibility. Our story begins in the calm waters above the town of Bikini Bottoms. As we descend beneath the waves, we find another day. Wait a minute! Hold your seahorses!
My manager's here.
Talk to me, Krabs.
We started out as a simple credit penny with cheese.
So what went wrong?
When the customer took a bite. No cheese! Ah, oh, but this has never happened!
Get a hold of yourself, Eugene. I'm going in.
I should be
so never cares. This has been eating on.
establishment, everything is going to be just fine.
Scared me up!
You got a name? Come on, Phil, stay with me. Only got one shot at this. Gotta have the right tools for the job. Bingo. I want you to do me a favor, Biffle.
What?
Say cheese.
Ah, the beginning. A little yellow friend awakes from his slumber and prepares for the biggest day of his life. Yet, despite his dreams, he is not honored with the manager position of the new Krusty Krab 2. So he sulks off to drown his depression in ice cream at the local Goofy Goobels. Across the street, jealous of Mr. Krabs' success, the diabolical Plankton hatches. And see, he steals King Neptune's crown and frames Mr. Krabs for selling it to the far-off and dangerous land of Cheryl City. Let us now join our heroes in the midst of their self-pity.
Hey, buddy. Come on. Wake up. It's 8 in the morning.
Well,
who's let your friends in?
Hey, buddy. Come on up here and join the party.
again. I'm just too kind.
participants, you may now use art tool to move.
Time to spin.
Better get going, Patrick. There's lots to do. Down from the cow conversion.
Patrick. I've been trying to find you all evening.
It's 8 in the morning, SpongeBob.
Oh, I'm late for work. Mr. Krabs is gonna kill me. Oh, Mr. Krabs.
Back at the Krusty Krab, King Neptune confronts Mr. Krabs about his alleged thievery. He asks if there is anyone present who may vouch for Mr. Krabs' character. And our yellow knucklehead McSpazitron shows up to accuse Mr. Krabs of being a horrible person. King Neptune zaps Mr. Krabs, causing SpongeBob to sober up quickly. He selflessly volunteers to journey to Shell City and retrieve the king's crown, freezing Mr. Krabs in place. King Neptune grants a 6-day reprieve, so SpongeBob and Patrick may attempt to retrieve the crown. King Neptune's daughter Mindy provides SpongeBob and Patrick with a magic mirror, through which she can communicate and assist our heroic duo. We continue as SpongeBob and Patrick arrive at the Paddy Waggle.
SpongeBob, Patrick, it's time to start your journey on the goodbye. Snark will take you on the edge of town. Don't let the paddy wagon take too much damage, or you'll have to start again.
Our journey begins. And then, wonderland,
daring, valiant, courageous! SpongeBob, you're driving a sandwich.
I'm just a sandwich. I'm grabbing paddy.
Jeez!
on to the next part of your journey. Here's your reward. Come back again if you want another driving town.
The chaos of the few nothing behind them, SpongeBob and Patrick begin their long journey called Shell City. However, with SpongeBob gone, all is not well. Plankton is now selling the Krabby Patty at the Chum Bucket, and with every purchase, customers are getting a mind-controlling bucket helmet. Squidward has discovered Plankton's plan to create an army of bucket heads. Will Squidward save the day? No. On the outskirts of town, SpongeBob and Patrick meet some of the charming locals who tell them they will not last long outside the city. But our friends are disagreeing. They should have listened. Our heroes are now stranded in a vast desert with only their feet for transportation.
So yes, now I have to teach her to bash me.
Now I come after.
Wow, that's amazing. Cranium powers to broadcast Plankton's hypnotized messages. Go do something soon. Be sure to see the unseen's control. Have courage, best shut it down.
Isn't this the really dangerous desert that no one has ever returned from?
But, no, I think that's the desert next to this one.
Well, in that case, I'll let those powers shut down in a jiffy.
Well, this video, okay?
and mouths. He's been everything fine to not happen.
Hey, Mom.
Last Plankton's propaganda powers are here on the edge of the desert.
Oh,
evil. Scrat, or slides from this area. I need you two to race down them and not those powers over.
So it's kind of water.
Don't worry, guys. Stay on the track, jump over off, and hit any Plankton signs you see along the way. Here's your reward.
Heroes, having foiled Plankton's evil plans, continue across the desert. But Plankton remains one stubby step ahead of them. He sends someone to make sure that they will fail. He is a vicious, ruthless killer named Demostop. Fortunately, SpongeBob and Patrick have discovered the paddy wagon in a parking lot. But the key is missing. So the only thing to do is to go into the rocky top spire and look for it. Good luck, my friends. You're going to need it.
Good news, Patrick. You've got enough Goofy Goober tokens for me to teach you a new ability. It's called... Yeah, you have to be in the air for that to work. Use it to cut buttons, break the floors, and even defeat enemies. The paddy wagon is parked outside, but you'll need to get the key back to use it.
That doesn't sound hard.
So you probably have to defeat all the thugs to get you.
That sounds hard.
You can do it, I know you can.
If you believe in me, then I can do it. Good key to the paddy wagon. Careful.
Yeah.